Okay, let's do it. We better not get in trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! Ugh. All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my god, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
Aw. This was little Izzy's.
I wanna play a game!
Let's get you back to Izzy. Why would this place be in the news? Can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs.
It's gonna be weird not waking up to Dylan's morning announcements.
Hey! You stop that!
Ready to roll?
Let's do it.
Finally. Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there. Nice steering, Tex.
Jinkies. Okay, so hypothetically, if I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick. Could be different. When you get his handle, hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up!
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
Sure. What's the victory?
2 months.
No technology.
I kind of thought it was nice to be offline.
Ugh, I didn't. Plus, my subs need me.
Oh, how'd they even get by for 2 months without you?
I will have you know that I have a very loyal and engaged subscriber base. I provide very important and educational lifestyle advice in the form of entertaining and hilarious video monologues. They rely on me.
Oh, totally. You're a big deal.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they're gonna be, like, really happy you're back.
My favorite spot?
The fire pit?
The island. Mad secluded, right? Is that smoke?
Should we tell someone?
It looks pretty contained. It's probably just Mr. H burning some stuff before, you know, he closes camp for the summer.
Yeah. Speaking of which, we should probably, you know, get back.
Oh yeah, worried Nick's, you know, gonna leave without you.
Well, no, they're probably like all waiting for us.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Everyone, yeah. Nick, waiting for you. All, everyone, same.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is, like, patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No.
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Ignore her, please.
Let's go.
Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here. Let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big
of
a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag. Thank you.
Cool. Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little me party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
You think I was listening to a podcast about you?
Okay, if anyone here had a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
Really,
so
look and smell like a butt.
No, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, weirdly enough. The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now? What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
If I did, would I be asking dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you, or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time you told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Yeah, nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
We had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up. Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Ugh.
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Come on, that's like super unchill.
Hey,
man.
Dude, I'm like the chillest flippin' bro in the whole world, man.
I just need some tunes for the ride, man.
All right, that's enough.
5 minutes? Like 5 minutes, that's all I need, man.
You said no, Dylan.
Okay, yeah, I know, but I was just...
I'll meet you at the van, okay? So, Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
Uh-oh. I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry.
Hello.
What? Because kids are kids. Don't need to be so much your bone.
They're almost out of here, all right?
You're cutting it pretty close. We don't want to have...
Just hold your damn horses, all right? Everything's A-OK on this end.
Bobby and I are geared up. If he's in the area, we'll get him.
This is a waste of time.
You know it, I know it.
No, should I have?
He's gone quiet.
Probably staying out of the way. Speaking of which, the longer you keep me on this damn phone, the longer it's gonna take me to get rid of these damn kids.
Yeah.
Of course. Adios.
Sorry, I wasn't listening. I was just like waiting. Like, I mean, I heard. I didn't hear what you were.
We're cool, champ. Just. Come on, it's sorry I pushed you out like that.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No, end of summer, busy, you know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah, it was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
You know, listen, whether or not I should, like... leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know, and my mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. You know, our family's small enough as it is.
Well, family is important, Ryan. Dang it.
This is just important to me.
You know what's important to me, Ryan? Trying to run a successful summer camp. I'm still trying to make up for the losses from last year. Terrified kids are bad for business. Phone calls I get from scandalized parents, nightmares, thumb-sucking, bedwetting. Think about that the next time you're flipping some yarn about the
Hagar Hackett's.
Just think next time, champ. Use the old skull muscle.
Sorry, I didn't realize it was such a big deal.
Gotta understand the repercussions of your actions, Buster. It's a big part of being a counselor, a leader.
Yeah.
Just stick to kumbaya next time, okay?
What's that?
You guys don't do kumbaya anymore? Good grief. I'm outgrowing my own cliches.
Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to drive in the dark. And safety is the first step towards fun. Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left them. Let's skedaddle.
Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You shouldn't have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell on the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go. What's the problem?
Ugh. Dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just like kaput.
All right, let me try.
What, dude, I'm telling you, all right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
The fuck, dude?
Enough. Enough, both of you. Shit. Come on.
All right,
come
dude, on. Chill. Chill, dude. Oh, God.
Everybody back! Now! 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 Jacob! Wait! 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 Wait!
I got this! Ow! Jeez! Dude, I was trying to help!
Okay. Okay.
Well, look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! No! Just stop. Let me think. Okay. Damn it. You're right. You're right. Yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're right. Hey, Brian, come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning, and we'll get you all on the road. You just have to keep everyone inside. Can you promise me you'll do that?
Wait, we have to stay inside until tomorrow? Why? Where are you going?
Ryan, I need you to trust me. Like I'm trusting you. Can you do that? Lock the doors! And for God's sake, keep the noise down!
So, what was that about?
He, said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do.
Of course.
Who cares what Chris told us to do? He's not our boss anymore. P-A-R-T. Why the fuck not? All right, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes. I'm in. Nick, you're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's in, obviously. My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in.
Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
Dude, he was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
I don't think he was trying to freak us out, Jacob. I think he was really freaked out by something.
Jesus Christ.
Chris seemed real serious about this, guys.
Just say you're in, man. Come on, one last night.
Yeah,
dude, he won't even know.
I promised.
No. Dude. It's all good. All right, we get it. You know, you don't want to disappoint Daddy.
Whatever, man.
It's gonna be fine, man. Trust me. It's gonna be chill.
All right. Hacketeers! Party planning committee, let's do this. Okay. First things first. Nick and Abby, you go get some firewood. Emma and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And, Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones for something. All right, let's do this!
Reason.